Lizzie and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got Perpetual Puzzle by Tenyo.
We certainly have.
You a fan of Tenyo stuff, Wayne?
I think Tenyo stuff is brilliant.
That's why he's on the show.
Tenyo is brilliant and it's Christmas.
Exactly. Thank you, Wayne. Right.
Thanks for asking my opinion. Glad you valued it.
This is based on the old puzzle. Was it Einstein's puzzle?
Yeah.
Which we've all seen, but it's taken it to a whole new level of magicness.
You're bigging it up now. Have you seen this sort of thing before?
This is brilliant.
It is brilliant.
It's ingenious.
Really
in
good.
Fact.
Jamie, can we get it off the sticks so we can come and have a look at this? Coming over nice and close now so we get a good look at this. You can see that this puzzle fits inside this frame perfectly. How does he get these bits out on the video so smoothly?
He does it very quickly and very smoothly.
He's almost like a master magician.
Isn't it?
Now, I've just realised that when I did this, I practiced it with the whole thing the other way up, so I need to go like this. Because I've only got it stuck in my head in that way, you know. So I remember the different ways that you do it. And the frame will go down like this. But this puzzle obviously fits in this frame absolutely perfectly. But I'm going to do something very, very strange. I'm going to add an extra bit into it. It's right there.
That looks
so
great.
Now it should be bigger. It should be bigger, shouldn't it?
And it's had a shape.
But if I put that just there and bring that round to there like that and slide all that up there, it still is the same size. But we know, don't we? We've seen it before. We know that it has to be bigger.
You look at the audience and you say, shall we add another piece?
Add another piece.
Add another piece.
Woo! And another piece goes in there. And this is going here.
Do it.
And this piece goes around here.
Yeah. God, can you remember what to do next?
And this bit
I'm getting
here.
Nervous now. Yes, you've done it.
But of course, all this means that we've added to the size of the puzzle.
We have added to the size of the puzzle.
And yet, amazingly, it still fits in the frame absolutely perfectly.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Jamie's got, look at his face. He's got no idea.
Fool Jamie Doherty.
Are we going to get back on the sticks in one smooth shot, Jamie? Are you going to manage to do that?
Come on, do it, Jamie. You can do it.
Very good. Are you going to stay there?
He's going to get a sore arm doing
right.
that.
Jamie, are you fooled?
I'm very fooled.
I watched the demo. When I saw it, I had no idea. It's absolutely fantastic. The reason that it's fantastic, the original used solid bits of wood, and that was kind of part of the method. Mm. Now you've got this bit where it's completely clear. All these bits are completely clear. You know, you can examine this. You could look at the frame. You could look at this. It's brilliant. Wayne?
It's ingenious. I want to have that. I would buy that because that's the kind of thing that you'd sit round after Christmas dinner. You're all sitting round having a little drink, and you say, "Yeah, go on then. I'll show you a little bit of magic." And you put this on the table.
Right. How much are you going to give it out of 100?
90.
Hang on.
Do you know what 90 means?
That means you've got to go out and
you've
do it.
You've got to do it at a gig.
You've got to do it. Right, so we're going to set you a challenge.
All right, I'll do it. I don't care, I'll do it. It's good enough.
Are you actually prepared to do it?
I'll go out and do it, yeah.
By the next time we film the Wizard Product Review, you come back with footage.
At a proper gig.
Or you've got to do a
or
forfeit.
Or on my phone or something.
Or a forfeit that I decide. If you've not got it, I decide.
Well, enjoy the forfeit. What's the forfeit?
I'm not telling you.
You're not allowed to wear your glasses at the Magic Circle.
Don't be ridiculous. I am coming up with a forfeit. I'm doing the forfeit and it's going to involve whipped cream and a chicken.
Exactly 90%?
Yeah, 90% is brilliant. I love it.
I'm actually giving this 95%. I really like this.
Wow.
I am going to give this, it's 96% from me. It's brilliant.
Really nice effect, made very well, took about 20 minutes rehearsal and we got it sorted. It's getting a worker of the week as well because it is such a great item. It's very easy to do, perfect for kind of a parlour show situation. You could even do it video projection on a screen, really strong. I had no idea how it worked because the fact that the puzzle is clear, like some of Tenyo's things, really, really baffling and very, very well made. It's getting a worker of the week. We'll tell you what the worker special is at the end.
One more note on this. What's going around on Facebook? The video, if you're doing the old Einstein's puzzle with the chocolate bar,
chocolate
isn't it?
Chocolate bar.
So you've got a modern day.
People think they understand it.
You've got a modern day lead into it, and then bam, smack them at the end.
Perpetual Puzzle by Tenyo, the first of this week's Workers of the Week.
So before we go back into the studio to see Wayne, we've set up a little plan, and that's, we've got a wink by the other brothers.
The other brothers.
The other brothers, but we've not been calling that. We've been telling Wayne they're called the Mario Brothers because of the moustache and the shirt and everything. So every time we've been talking about it, we've called it the Mario Brothers. Wayne's going to introduce a link, and hopefully he's going to think and say that they're called the Mario Brothers.
This could end in disaster.
Hopefully.
Okay, so next up is Wink by the Mario Brothers.
You're right, Dave.
Brilliant.
You're right.
Dave's having a moment.
I can't wink. They all said wink when
they
say wink.
To do?
I can't wink.
He's having a stroke.
I can't wink. Good awareness this week. Tell us about the effect, Wayne. What's the effect?
So, you've got a wine glass. You can hold it up in front of your audience. You can wave your hand in front of it.
Can you borrow this wine glass?
Use a borrowed wine glass. Yeah, you can lift it up off the table. Someone's there. Got to have a little bit of liquid in there. Wave it in there, and an image will appear. Say like a four of a hearts or something. This looks like a smoky image in amongst the wine. It's supposed to look like it's inside there.
What did you think to it, Wayne?
It wasn't for me. It wasn't for me.
Why not?
It doesn't. It looks what I think it is. If you're guessing how this works, I think that's what it looks like.
Which is an interesting theory of magic. Who was it that said, if you have to leave more than one theory for something a trick, if it can only be done one way, I've read this in a book, if there's only in one solution to it, then people are going to go straight to it. It's maybe not quite deceptive enough. However, I think for an eye dent, like for like maybe a special on TV, just a bit flashing and then something written in the back of the glass and then quickly going away.
Well,
I think it might be quite cool for a YouTube video.
That's what
it's 30 minutes long, isn't it? The download you get with it.
They're talking very much about how they actually do it in the real world, and they address the problem. So the big problem for this would be that it can only be performed on one person at a time. Now, they try to solve this in a way, in such a way where they say you might have somebody say, pick the four of hearts, using your special magician ways, and then go to one person in the group, the one person will be able to see it, and so you're going to influence that person to be able to see the chosen card within the glass. And then, so they experience a trick, and then the audience react by reacting to that person's reaction. Kind of like if you remember the old specs effects thing with
and
the 3D arts.
There was actually a thing with a crystal ball.
In fact, they actually said about the crystal ball.
It was an old idea, but I think even
Mark Oberon used it.
I was just about to say, he does do that.
And it looks amazing when you see it just glide by. You can't have that kind of animation with this. It's not as strong.
No.
It's a nice moment, but I think you'd struggle to get it into a working routine, and I've not really seen anything to give me any confidence that it could be. How much are you going to give it?
Oh, mate.
You get gimmicks, you get the 30...
It is, it's all way,
it works.
It's made up well.
30
it is
minutes,
made up well.
30-minute DVD explaining it all and that. The gimmicks work, but how well is...
And you can make your own gimmicks.
Yeah.
You know, if you wanted to have your name appear in it or something.
Yeah, it's not for me. 62% for this...
I think that's generous.
Well, I'm kind of giving the benefit of the doubt, and because it's a reputable company that they've kind of maybe used it, and it's stronger than I think. Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, it is what it is. It does work. You can't take that away from them. It would be kind of cool for a YouTube video, just as a clip, not as an effect in itself, just as a quick flash over a second. But for that, I've got to go close to what Wayne's saying. I'm going to say 55%.
And Wayne, from the start, we were watching it. It was only 30 minutes. You were going, I'm not feeling this. We filled up the glass. We tried it. We tried it with coloured liquid. We tried it with all the time.
We did give it a good go.
You've never been convinced, have you?
Unfortunately not. No, it looks like what you're guessing it's going to be.
And Hammond, did you give a mark?
15.
Hammond gives you a pull. Which one? Again, which one? That one, with he knows it. Shall we go with the one that he knows?
Shall we go with it?
Let's go with the one that he knows.
Is that a fair choice?
That was a fair choice. Is that a fair choice?
That was fair.
There we go, right.
Good boy. Good boys, fair choice. Do we need to get it off the sticks?
Right. Get it off the sticks.
We've got Blammo's water bowl.
Blammo's water bowl, just here. Blammo's picked the card, we've got his water bowl, he's even had a biscuit. Blammo has freely selected a card, first with his paw, and then to verify it with his nose. Remember the card. You can have a look at the card. You can have a look at the card. Yeah. The card will go face
don't
down there.
I don't want to
see it. No. The magic water bowl.
Look straight into the magic water bowl.
Some magic might happen. Because that's...
Ooh.
And as quickly as it comes.
Hopefully.
As slowly
it's
as it
really
comes.
It's really clear now.
As slowly as it comes. It goes.
Disappears. Whoa. Awesome.
So that is Blammo's water bowl. It's not called Blammo's water bowl.
No, it's called water crystal.
Water crystal. Okay, so obviously you've seen the effect. The props do work. It is what it is. It's a beginner magic type thing.
Yeah, it looks alright. Yeah. It's a nice toy.
What are you going to learn to do this? And I don't want to spoil. I don't want to give any exposure away. But you're going to learn how to make somebody pick the right card.
Yeah. Okay. And there's the cross cut method of that is described in the instructions. The effect itself, the reveal of the playing card, you do get extra reveals in there as well. There's a couple of other cards. There's a blank one, so you could write something down inside, like a design or a word or something like that. I don't think it'd be that hard for you to start, tailoring it to your own reveals if you wanted to use it. It's just kind of justifying this thing in the real world. It does work quite well. Although we have had a couple of issues, haven't we?
It's maintenance.
And that's only, I think, because we possibly didn't take care of it.
Of the gimmick. We did what we shouldn't have done, which is left the water in too long.
Yeah. We didn't read the instructions.
Yes, what we did.
And we're doing it again now. Yeah, if you leave the water in too long, the gimmick that helps you do it will morph.
Yeah. Look after your props, will look
after
you.
And you need to leave it in a Chinese cookbook for at least an hour, and then you're ready to do it again.
Page 56.
So it's what it is. We've demmed it. We've kind of shown it. It works. It's very clever
how it
all comes apart, and you
it does
can
look right.
Tailor
it does look
the gimmicks, and
good.
When the card appears in the water bowl and then diffuses away again,
it
looks quite good. And you just do that by swirling it. It works itself. It's not examinable or anything like that. It's just a visual effect. How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
Just through the visual effect alone, I would say about 75.
Yeah, it works. We're not saying a professional magician should buy this, so our marks aren't going, oh yeah, if you're a professional magician, go out and do this. But people getting into magic, it definitely works.
Yeah.
70% from me.
Okay, I'll give it, not as much as that. So 67. 67. This next one is called Psychogravity, but before we get to that, let's have a chat, Wayne, about how the dealer dems, the lecture dem. What is a lecture dem for anybody that doesn't know?
What is a lecture dem?
Lecture dem is different to a lecture. Different to a lecture, different to a dealer dem.
Okay.
Difference is when you have a working professional magician who likes the products that are coming out from a certain shop, who says to the owner, why not let me go out and demonstrate how good your effects are to all the magic clubs, wherever who wants to book them?
It's a good idea. I wish we'd thought of that.
And do you know a working professional magician that you take with you?
It's actually... You see how angry I got then?
Oh, because I don't mind coming and helping.
Poor Blammo.
Yeah, I'm just kidding.
Oh, okay. He's rattled now. So who have you done it for so far?
We've done 14 clubs so far in the UK.
And still more to
it's
go.
Been, got more booked up for the next year. I'm not doing anything over December because I'm out doing the gigs and everything.
Yeah.
But it's all about going out, learning about the effects like Mystery Solved and CoinVex and things like that that you are not too sure whether you want to get it or not. You can go along to your local club, get them to book me. I come along, I demonstrate everything, and then you get to handle the props afterwards to see whether or not it's going to work. Do you know what I mean?
And you've got your own take and full presentation.
My
difference,
I do like everybody, I think if you're a working pro, you do try to find out a way you can do it yourself.
Yeah.
And I go out and I do mystery solved a completely different way than it is on the DVD.
Yeah, you do.
And I just want to share that with everybody. And it gives everybody a nice idea, thinking, yeah, actually, you know what? This is going to work for me. Well, you see my OmniPen.
Yeah.
Mm. I do.
And you explain the routines, let them play with the gimmicks, yeah. Show them the latest stuff coming out, mm-hmm. Give them stuff for free that they don't need to buy anything, just stuff
there's
generally
little
from your lecture.
As well. Yeah, there's stuff in what I've actually got from the Chatterfox lecture, so they're going to be getting all that information for free anyway.
Not just a dealer dem.
It's what, that's what a lecture dem's about. That's what a lecture dem's about.
And if they want to book the World Magic Shop lecture dem, how would people get in touch with you?
WayneFoxMagic@gmail.com. Give me a little email. Now, here's the thing.
Yeah.
I don't charge to come out to clubs to do it. I charge for my expenses only. That's what it is. When I hear people say, I'm going out, going to go and do a dealer dem, and I'm charging them so many £100 to do it, that's like ringing up a car dealership, going over there, and them charging you £50 to go out and test drive their car. That's not what you want. You want someone to come out, show you what it's about, and then you get all this free information.
Good
stuff.
And
then stuff. You get the special deals as well at the end.
Let's see if psychogravity may be something that you'll be using on the lecture dem in future.
Shall we?
First of all, everything can be examined and checked out that we're going to use with this. Everything before and afterwards. You can look at that board just there. There's nothing there.
Just nothing there.
And this bit here and this. Make sure you can't see through this.
It's like a thermometer, isn't it?
Okay.
He examines stuff like a chimp, doesn't he?
He's
like being in a zoo today.
Right, okay. So
Flabbo's got better table manners than this bloke.
Right, and we need four things that you can write on here. You can put playing cards underneath. It can literally, if you were doing a trade show and you wanted to use this at a trade show, it could be the points of the product or anything like that. So four things, what are we going to use?
Let's try to do four good things about Wayne Fox.
Four good things.
Yeah, Jamie, name a good thing about Wayne Fox.
Glasses, sunglasses.
Right, so I'll put glasses there.
G-L-A-S-S-E-S.
Okay, and
you'd have a good thing about Wayne Fox.
I'll put charisma.
Oh, come on, eh? I don't want to go on about it.
And charisma.
Is that how you spell it?
Charisma.
Kinda.
That's it, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, got it. Spot on. Glasses. Charisma.
Another good one.
Yeah.
I think that's it, isn't it?
Come on the show, they say.
Boyish good looks.
Okay, good
just
looks.
Just put good looks.
Good looks. And I'll put Tom Ford.
It is a little bit tonight.
Ooh, yeah, it is Tom Ford.
It is Tom Ford, because I have been out with Wayne, and the amount of women that stop him and go, ooh, what's that you're wearing? So we've got three different positions. A is glasses, B is charisma, C is good looks, and D is Tom Ford. Wayne. I'm going to get you to mark one of these in a minute. And what you've got to do, when you mark it, put a dot on it. So I'm going to get Wayne to put a dot, I'm not going to look, in this board a bit here.
All right.
A big dot next to one of those, okay? Either A, B, C or D. And then when you've done it, put it down flat on the table and put that in front.
All right, okay, right. Turn away.
I think the lid's on the other side. Right, I'm not looking.
And you, monkey boy.
That's Ali Cook. Never saw Monkey Magic.
I did see Monkey Magic. There's plenty of people who wouldn't. That would be quite offensive.
Put that down. Okay, you ready?
Hang on a minute. We've done it.
I hope this works. Oh, you've put the slope on as well.
Oh, yeah.
Right, hang on.
We saw rehearsals. We were just trying to help you. We weren't meant to put the slope on.
Okay, I want you to send your thoughts.
I'm a spectator, don't.
I forgot to look what you did.
Send your thoughts towards the gravity disc. And remember.
Only clean ones.
I haven't looked. No. Right?
Okay.
Place it here. Oh, is it glasses? No.
No.
Is it charisma?
No.
No. It's moved on a little bit further.
No.
It's gone to Tom Ford.
No.
Stopped on Tom Ford. Is
no,
it going to go?
Look. Oh no, where's it stopped?
Good looks.
Tom Good Looks.
Good Looks.
Tom Ford is the last one. It stopped
on Good Looks.
There.
It has stopped on Good Looks.
And is what? That correct? Is that the one you selected?
It is the one I selected.
And you can good see looks. There.
The dot if we on Good Looks, hold it up to the light. Everything examinable.
There we go. What do you think to it?
Again, Christmas dinner, Christmas round the table is going to puzzle a lot of people.
Do you know what is?
It
really...
does look very magical when it's moving, and it kind of sort of stops, then continues to go again. It's quite magical.
What is good, and I had no idea how this worked, is when they put this dot. You could put a bit of electrician's tape over that.
Anything, yeah, anything.
And you would have no idea.
It's and that yet... bit was actually very magical that they know. Where the dot is.
You that's, don't
that's
look.
Very, that's ingenious.
Guess what? I'm changing. Right, here we go. Right, here, this this bit is a bit of fun with it, right?
Yeah.
That actually could be used as a principle in another type
definitely.
Of effect.
Yes. Definitely.
You know, yeah, so it's kind of almost worth buying to figure out how you're figuring out
just to say,
where that needs to land.
Just to
actually.
Say, cover that up there, and yet you know.
Mm.
Even though it's completely covered up, you know where they've marked something. So, yeah, it is... kind of clever. This, we had our issues with it. You have to prepare the gimmick. This was the longest thing to prepare out of all the Tenyo stuff.
Any time that I've spent on the Wizard product review, this is the thing, the longest thing that we've spent on.
Which was 7 minutes. We were setting it up. We had to change it. We had to reset it up again. We got it working. Then it wasn't working. Now we've got it working. It is kind of reliable.
Yeah.
It does work. It's whether you want to do that effect. It's quite baffling. The dot here did fool me. I'm giving it 77%.
You had something... I know this was what you said, the same thing about the Einstein puzzle. But it's the same thing with this. If you bought this for a kid, for a seven-year-old kid, at Christmas, which is what this type of stuff's aimed at, right? This is going to be great fun getting it to work. The kid will cry at some point because he thinks it's not going to work. But that is part of the fun. If you've got children, you know that. Taking them on that roller coaster ride of emotions. Then you finally get it working and you've got the big cheers from around the family dinner table.
I like the idea of the playing cards like this that was in the instructions. Mm. So you put under the playing cards and then the disc moves along and eventually stops on the correct playing card.
Kind of like...
How much are you going to give it, Sean? Already at
9 minutes. 61%.
61.
It works.
65.
Finally, we've got The Journey by Matt Johnson, who's born in Sheffield.
In Sheffield.
And he's got that accent, hasn't he?
He's channeling some showbiz American comedian, and he comes out through his own body into the whole magic world, and he releases what actually looks like incredible magical effects. I wasn't aware that Matt Johnson was bringing stuff out. But you know, this is really
good. Card
really
at any
good.
Number. So for anybody that doesn't know,
Holy Grail.
Living under a rock. Apparently, it's the Holy Grail.
Some people think
magic.
It's the Holy Grail. Don't
yeah, the idea is that you get somebody to name a card, name a number, you count down to that position, and their chosen card is at that number. Now, what I want to say up front is there's not just one version on the DVD. I think there's four in all, is there? Four? Yeah, there is four in all. Some of them have got a little bit more set up. Some of them you may have to use a little bit more pocket space.
One of them's been released before in a PDF version. But that's the last one on the video, I think.
Been released before. But... the shuffled deck version, which you could use a borrowed deck for, is the one... is it the one
it's
I
the
like
first
best?
One.
Wayne liked it best, yeah, but you like the other one after.
Well, look, right, here's the thing.
Okay.
Is it with a brand... What's great about the one that you like, why it's so great, is it is just with a random
deck.
Shuffle deck. If you're prepared to put a bit of work in, because he does teach you things with gimmick decks, and you want that just pure, most magicalist version, I think it's the second one on the DVD.
Yeah, okay.
I
think the one you're going to end up using, if you can do the sleight of hand move, which is...
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's an aspirational move because you are going to get it. You're going to get it eventually. It's one
it's
of those
It's a timing thing.
You might be able to do it already, fair to say. You can do it already.
Yeah, I could, yeah,
you
I
can
you,
do it already.
You're a hard worker, you're going to be able to do it already.
I now want to learn this move because this is such a direct effect. But I do prefer, even though it's not as pure as the second version, as far as people are concerned, they're picking any card and that card is at that number. You kind of have to...
showboat it a little bit and kind of go, okay, is it in here somewhere? And then you get the number. Mm-hmm. I do think the first version is the one that I would end up using in the right conditions.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Because it is literally, you've got the deck, they name a card, you make sure it's in there, you could cut the deck a few more times, they name any number and you count down. They turn over the card themselves. The deck is completely ungimmicked. There's nothing special
it's
about
very
it.
Clean.
The card
very
is
very
at that number. Mm. It's brilliant. That's why it's getting a Worker of the Week. We'll tell you a bit more about that very, very shortly. But tell us about the second version, which you preferred. It's four in all.
Oh, yes. So, well, we can't really talk about it without it's any card, any number.
It uses something that Joshua Jay popularised in his Inferno
effect.
Which
is called Inferno, can't we? Yeah, which is at the beginning of that. And that's what makes this just a little bit more powerful, because rather than, you know, name a card and then having
what
that unclean bit at the beginning,
he
just goes straight into the, clean magic.
What I like about it, it makes perfect sense because cards have been eliminated.
Yeah.
And the way Matt describes it in the presentation is the cards have been eliminated and they've been put back in the box.
Oh, yes.
So at the end of the elimination process...
That was the outcome that was on the... In his performance. Yeah. There's other
outcomes. It's going to happen most of the time.
But most of the time. But what's great is if it doesn't happen, they're all still just as clean and great. You're still going down that path.
But I did like it when he said, right, we're eliminating cards. They're all going back into the box.
Brilliant.
There's 51 cards in the box and you've got the one card there. Now I want you to slide it in anywhere you like, and I think it was 28 on the DVD. It goes in, gets slid in, and then he says, now let's go back to reality. We've got a deck sat there. He takes that deck out, counts down, 28th card. It's the card they've just freely chosen with that extra bit of patter and script from Joshua Jay that is absolutely brilliant.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
They're the two best versions. There's another version that's going to take up a little bit more pocket management and pocket space, which we didn't like as much. You could argue that it's even cleaner, but from a working perspective, I think it's better.
I just think, as soon as you look at the film, on the description, as soon as they see that first one, there's people out there who can already do this move.
Yeah.
You're going to go, that's ingenious, and you'll be able to do it immediately.
And you can use it as part of your regular working
set.
Oh, it's great.
You could be using a deck of cards and you could just literally say, oh, you're thinking of a card, now name a number. You could stick it in the middle of a multiple card finder routine.
Or at the end of a multiple card. I'm already thinking, you know, at the end of my multiple card find routine, before the deck's vanished, I've already manipulated the card into the right place that it needs to be. Or no, not even that. One person at the end is just thinking of a card.
Yeah.
So the deck vanishes. When I bring the deck back out again, you were just thinking of a card.
We're all going to use it. I want to learn it. He's well on the way to learning it.
Da-da-da.
Wayne can do it.
I'm
going to
add 52-1.
You can do it already.
You can do it on there.
How much are you going to give it?
90%.
95%.
I'm going to give it 97%. I think it's one of the best projects I've seen in a long time, which is why, as well as the perpetual puzzle, it's getting the Worker of the Week this week. If you order either The Journey by Matt Johnson or The Perpetual Puzzle by Tenyo Magic, by midnight on Friday, you will get Tom Wright's stand-up magic absolutely free. Still to this day, as far as I'm concerned, the best close-up routine of a chop cup you've ever seen, the best streamline handling of bottle through table, card through mouth. There's loads of guys, not through mouth,
card
in
through
mouth.
I've seen a card through
it's
mouth.
Amazing, I know, with copy decks and that. Let's not talk
it's
about
incredible.
That. Card in mouth is a very commercial routine that lots of people have been done, and also the full psychology of stand-up magic explained that could change the way you perform close-up magic. You do it.
I do it.
I do it.
You do it what? Stand-up magic?
Yeah. It works. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Don't forget to get in touch with Wayne, who is now, from this moment, on a challenge to go out and perform Perpetual Puzzle.
It's not even a challenge.
In the real world, you've got to do it. You've got to have the footage next time you come back on the Wizard Product Review. Until then, I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review. It's only me doing it. It's only me doing it.
What about the...
Good boy.
We can do it.
I'm not a psycho. I'm just going to have a little bit of magic at three. All you got to do is rock. Are you up for it?